No, you must. They're okay. We are measuring the X of pulsar period, the binary period, the intensity, the function of time, and so on. But what do we learn from such studies? One of the important thing is that we want to know what is the mass of the neutron star or black hole. Okay, and we can obtain some idea, some estimate of the mass of the X-ray emitting source by doing the studies of X-ray source and also its optical counterpart. Because take example of Centaurus X3, we know the visible star, so we can measure what is known as the radial velocity of the star, the velocity with which it moves towards and away from us, and there and we know the binary period, we know the X-ray period, we can measure the so we know also the velocity of the X-ray object. Okay, so by knowing this and the orbital inclination which you can derive from the shape of the X-ray eclipse, we can measure actually we can estimate the mass of the neutron star. And in fact, masses of large number of neutron star have been measured by this technique. Now there are large number of radio binary pulsars, and therefore independently mass of the neutron stars have also been derived from radio observation. And all these studies show that masses of neutron stars are typically in the range of over 1.5 solar masses. We can also measure magnetic field of the pulsars. I told you earlier that neutron stars found in X-ray pulsars have a typical field of a few times 10 to 12 Gauss. But how do you know that? If you study the X-ray spectrum of a X-ray pulsar, then sometimes you find an absorption line, which is known as a cyclotron line. These lines are produced, in the intense magnetic field of the neutron star. I'm not going to details of that, except to remark that when the magnetic field is very high, the electrons are moving, their orbits get quantized, and you get cyclotron emission line, absorption line. And these lines typically lie in 10 to 60 kV band, and large number of such lines have been detected, okay, in about 20 X-ray pulsars, and from which the estimate of magnetic field has been derived and found to be in the range of 2 to 8 times 10 to 12 Gauss. So by study of X-ray binaries, we can measure the mass of the X-ray source, we can measure the magnetic field of the neutron star, and we can also learn about what processes give rise to X-ray emission. I told you about the